the same age as Reagan Knights, and welcome to your Tuesday broadcast. I'm Senior Nick Young, and this is Sophomore Connor Bullis. Looking at Nightcast events this last week, the IBLA club competed in the state competition. SMR had a strong showing with three teams taking first place and another taking second place in their category. Congrats to Lance Casimir, Dominic Wilkins, Nick Dowdle, Nick Gray, Eric Rivenberg, Dakota Davey, Tyler Dameron, Justin Snellings, Michael Lopez, and Ethan Rubin, who will now go on to the national FBLA competition next month.
16 students in our fine arts department have been accepted into our brand new chapter of Tri-M Music Honor Society. Those students are Brianna Brophy, Catherine Dowdle, Nicholas Dowdle, Corey Isley, Bridget Flynn, Emily Grace, Elisa Angelito, Rebecca Johnson, T.J. Kromnecker, Samantha Martinson, Casey Miller, Ryan Miller, Jonathan Napini, Michael Napini, Megan Schreier, and Claire Tennant.
Looking at events for this week, our students have participated in the Poetry Alliance with St. Mary's College. Will recite their poems on Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. in Romeo Hall. Their poetry is amazing, and Dr. Michael Glasner, former Poetry Laureate of Maryland, always reads some of his original pieces. Our fine arts students will showcase their talent this Friday night as band, chorus, dance, and visual arts perform at 7 p.m. in Romuald Hall. Bring your family and friends to a free night of wonderful music, song, and dance.
On Wednesday, the Envirothon team will take part in a state competition. Good luck. Ms. Stevens will lead her Habitat for Humanity group to help repair a house this Saturday as part of the countywide Christmas in April program. For more fun, the St. Mary's Reichen Knights baseball team take on the D.C. Padres at 4:30 on Sunday at the Blue Crab Stadium. Our own Father Young and Father Dave Wells are members of the D.C. Padres. The D.C. Padres, a unique baseball team consisting entirely of the Catholic priests and seminarians, will be playing the Reichen Knights in the seventh inning game of the baseball game on Sunday, April 28th at Regency Furniture Stadium, home of the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. The Blue Crabs play at 2 p.m., and the Padres and Knights will be playing them around 4:30. Go to the DC Padres website at dcpadres.com for more details and to obtain a coupon flyer that anyone can present at the ticket window on game day. And you can purchase it for $5, which is better than the normal price for a ticket for general admissions, which is $9.
Friday will be a tag day to benefit the all-nighter. Don't forget the AP exams are coming up. It is a chance for you to save some time and money by getting college credit for your classes.
Now on to Dean Murph with sports.
Thanks, Connor and Nick. Here with your Tuesday sport broadcast is yours truly, Daniel Murphy. Taking a look at our past week's sports results, over the weekend, track placed 11 out of 40 teams in their meet, while the SMR boys baseball won their game on Saturday. The SMR vs. DeMatha game lived up to its hype of being the game of the year. Although we lost 6-7 in double overtime, our boys played awesome. Nathan Blondino had 3 goals, while Garrett Ignazic had a great game and goal. Looking ahead at this week, to highlight some of today's games, today baseball plays DeMatha and lacrosse plays Ireton. Thursday and Friday, track has an away meet at Penn's Relay, and on Friday, boys lacrosse plays St. John's, while our tennis team plays in the WCAC finals. Good luck, Knights. Now on to G-Rad the Weatherman.
Thanks, Dan, and here's your weather for the week. Today, it's going to be a high of 62 and a low of 45. It's partly cloudy for most of the day. And on Wednesday, it's going to be sunny out with a high of 72 and a low of 46. The same goes for Thursday. It's going to be sunny also with a high of 63 and a low of 41. And also Friday, it's going to be sunny, which is good. And it's going to be a high of 68 and a low of 50.
Hi, I'm Gerard, and today's SAT word of the day is bewilder. It's a verb. Means to confuse, to perplex, or to mystify. Sent to the store to buy shampoo for his sister, Andrea was utterly bewildered by the selection. There were shampoos for straight hair, long hair, limp hair, fair hair. Overwhelmed, he left empty-handed. Today's SAT word of the day is bewilder.
From all of us here at Nightcast,
you stay classy, St. Mary's Reichen.